ministru Rinkeviču un Horvātijas ekonomikas ministru vietnieci Ālijas un Ēlētāju ministrs Marijas Pečinovičas un Buričas kopīgo preses konferences un vārts Ālētāju ministru Rinkeviču kopā.
Vienvērtoties žurnālisti, tētās sarunas ar Horvātijas
less importantly to European states that want to develop further visit to friendly Latvia on the centennial of your independence, as the two states that have in some way similar struggle for independence, freedom, which are two very cherished words in our two languages. I think this was a very great opportunity to celebrate also this in this working official visit on our future. So we share a lot of income, and I think that's where partly our understanding comes from. So we have, as you mentioned, we have good political relations, which we want to deepen, and now as member states of the two important institutions, but also in the broader framework. We think that there is room for improvement of our economic relations. They were mentioned three direct needs that are seasonal for three big cities that are our seaside, so Dubrovnik, Rijeka, and from 2 to 3 days ago split. So we are seeing a lot of tourists coming to Croatia, but also growing tourists coming to Latvia, and we think that with this interconnectivity through via Air Baltic, but also in different ways, we can have a bigger boost in our exchange, not only in tourism, but in other areas. We have so far exchanged in electrical industry and also in food processing, but we think there is a room at least from Croatian side in pharmaceutical, IT, and generally in new technology. So we believe that we will open up more business to business communication and also on this political level. We believe that we can cooperate also in the area of energy and transport, and that I discussed earlier on also with the colleague Minister of the Economy, because this kind of interconnectivity in fact makes our countries even closer, and in today's world and today Europe it is very important to be interconnected in different ways, be it that digital or hard connections through transport by air or by road in different ways. Among bilateral topics, we mentioned that we had joint interest in the area of defense, and Croatia is participating very strongly, having in mind our size in enhanced warfare presence. The number of our people are there about 270 at the moment. So we really look forward to our further work on within the NATO framework, and of course the first next occasion is the NATO summit, where important things will be discussed and where we also share views on a number of topics. Not to forget about PESCO, which is a cooperation within the European Union format. It is very important because it provides for project-based cooperation. We already identified ourselves that we have at least one area where we want to cooperate, and as PESCO is developing, there will be more areas. We are sure that there will be also more for that. As among countries, very important on people-to-people contacts, we believe that we can also enhance our cultural relations. Croatian city of Rijeka will be the capital, European capital of culture in 2020, when we are also holding our first presidency. So also your experiences in that respect will be important for us, but we believe that culture doesn't need to be translated. This is this kind of connection that goes really to the hearts of people, and we believe that we, as having rich cultures on both sides, that we can do more. We have a good cooperation between projects for time that was from Latvian side helping Croatia. One way now we are working together with the third countries, and that goes well, so we are looking forward to work more, and there is a new project, I think the newest one is in Bosnia and Herzegovina, that we will work together in time to come. In further, we exchange opinions on that we have similar or share viewpoints on a number of current EU topics, especially Brexit, future of Europe, the future of Northern Ireland, and financial framework, you already mentioned that, where we underline the importance of in maintaining the adequate level of financing in cohesion and in common agricultural policy, but also some other criteria that are important for what stands. You mentioned also very important organization, and for the moment the last one, that is for Croatia interesting as an international forum to join in, that this is OECD. So we are already participating in some of the committee meetings of the OECD for time being, but now we wish and we labeled our wish to start accession negotiations, and thank you very much for the support, the Latvian support in that, especially in the special capacity that you have to see us for OECD enlargement. There are much bigger issues, different opinions and different in different countries, so it is very important that we have support from the Latvian side and strong support on that side. We are looking forward to share our experiences in the new presidency. In fact, there is at least one similar thing that was the case for Latvian presidency in 2015 and will be in Croatia in 2020. Not only that we will have the multi-annual financial framework most probably to wind up and finish, but also the fact that the institutional setup will be completely new after the elections of the European Parliament, new European Commission, then this setup was exactly the same for Latvia in 2015. So who better can give an advice and experience share than Latvia? So we will be certainly coming back to you to have that as our presidency is approaching and the first half of 2020 is behind the board. We also exchange views on our neighborhoods, equally our neighborhood in Southeast Europe, and our positions regarding enlargement, as on some kind of countries of Eastern Partnership, but also on Ukraine. So there we also share very similar views that we want to have enlargement, but enlargement based on criteria, and we in Croatia would coin it strong support, fair, but strict. That is that all countries that want to join the European Union really need to go to the criteria. For Eastern Partnership, we were talking in particular through the views of the next NATO summit. We would wish that Ukraine is called for a meeting with NATO, and we agree that it's both countries share this view that it would be a hard time to have this meeting at the NATO level. And one of the final things for this introduction regarding the Western Balkans and enlargement, it was just a few days ago, last week, there was a Sofia summit. It was after 15 years, first time after the Thessaloniki summit, that the EU enlargement was brought on that level to be discussed. Our aim of our presidency and our wish is to have, and this is in the conclusions of the Sofia summit, that in Croatia, in 2 years' time, we will organize the Zagreb summit. We call it Zagreb summit 2 because the first Zagreb summit took place in 2000. When Croatia was actually started with the European path, that was launching our stabilization and association negotiations. For us, that was very, I would say, some kind of historic event, at least if you look at the European contexts, European integration contexts. And this was the first time that the European Council met for this thing outside of the European Union. So we wish that the summit during our presidency in Zagreb summit 2 would be more pro-enlargement, but also we always underline that we are pro-enlargement, but we are the countries that are candidates, and to be candidates need also to show commitment and So I hope it will be met in 2020 and that we could call the next summit that could be more than a joint summit than so far. And finally, I would like to thank my hosts here in Latvia. I'm here only 24 hours right now, but I feel like at home. And we agreed also that we should work more closely and meet more closely on bilateral level. There is one trap when you work together in many international fora, so then you meet so often that sometimes you have a feeling that you meet all the time. For instance, I met your parliamentary secretary in last 6 or 7 days, 3 times, including this one in Latvia. So the feeling is that we are cooperating very well because we know each other and we work together in Brussels. But nothing can replace this kind of exchange. And I'm very glad and grateful to have this meeting here. And of course, I take this opportunity, I didn't say that at the meeting, to invite my colleague Edgars to have next meeting, possibly next year, ahead of our presidency in Croatia. Thank you very much.
Paldies, Buriči, un zēmēs, ka viņi cilvēks padziņīties uz laiku.
And then we had Spurnācionālās Inkrumu Nemāca Sēģinājums Latvijas cilvēks, un tad jautājumu no Horvātijas ministrēju. Par šo sadarbību tieši pēc kā ietvaros, kā tā varētu ar Horvātijām Latvijā notikot, bet praktiski, kā jūs redzat, minējāt, tie vismaz viena šī te nozēta par pirmēnošanās, kur tā sadarbība varētu arī notikt uz publikas.
Thank you very much. PESCO is a completely new one among the 17th project that PESCO forward with us first. We in Croatia opted for 5, and among 5, there is actually one that is the same that Latvia also opted, which is military interoperability. We think, and I think really, this is very important in the framework of a lot of NATO and defense actions that we are having together. This interoperability is in fact the key, how you work together, how you operate. So this is for the time being, we didn't discuss that in detail, unfortunately. This was too short visit to work for such a detailed discussion in depth, but this is the area which we consider very important, and you must know that, you know, we are ministers of foreign affairs. In fact, a real hard work is on ministers
for somebody else.
For ministers of defense. So how they will do it, or how the countries will do it, is more in detail to work on that level. But just to say that this is one area where certainly we see need, and where we see additional value for.
Thank you.
Paldies, Kristiņ. Paldies jums par laiku.